almost 5 years ago when I came to the branch, I talked to Larry and found out he was a poet, and he and I decided that it would be a good idea to get people in the community together, for poets to hear one another, and for the people in the community to be able to hear what talent there was. And so Larry started it, and every year that we've done it, he's done more. And as you can see from the food and the turnout, it's every year been a better success. We have videos of the earlier ones, and we've had some poets here, some all the way through. I'm really happy to see you all here tonight, and I'm going to turn it over to Larry because he's going to MC the whole program. And the program tonight will be, the first hour will be compressed. No, every poet who's going to speak will speak during the first hour, because the first hour is going to be on cable TV, so you'll get to see some of us citywide as well. So here's Larry.
Hello there, and thank you all very much, and welcome to the fourth annual Bayview Wadden Poetry Recital. It is indeed a pleasure to see such a nice audience here, and I think we're going to have a really great show tonight, and we have some really gifted poets here, some of the best poets in the country. And before the show begins, I would like to take this time to some special dedications to some very special people. I would like to pay tribute to Julia Wimberly, who was deceased a couple of weeks ago. We used to go to business seminars and meetings. She was really a wonderful person. And I'd like to dedicate this recital to her. Would like to also dedicate this recital to a good friend of mine, Calvin Pritchett. His mother passed away. And also I'd like to dedicate this to Tangela Collins. This is her 18th birthday. There's a mother and a sister right there. She wasn't able to make it, but happy birthday there, Tangela, and wish you many more. And we're going to get the show on the road now. And it is indeed a great pleasure to, I know this young lady's mother and grandmother, and I met her for the first time at church, and her mother told me that she was into poetry too, so I said, well, read a couple of poems for me, and it was awesome, you know. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our youngest poet this year, Amanda Shelton. Please come forward, Amanda.
Dreams. Do you want to be a doctor? That might be your dream. Do you want to be a dentist and your teeth will shine and gleam? Do you want to be a hairdresser? That might be the best. But if you have a niece or nephew, they might be a pest. Do you want to be an artist? You need good drawing skills. You could also be a vet and take care of a pet. You could be a clown and never show a frown. You could be a book writer and sometimes be a book fighter. Oh no. My family. My family is many generations. We are all God's creations. Whether short or tall, big or small, we are not from different nations. My relatives are big, my relatives are small. My relatives are short, my relatives are tall. We are not prejudiced, that is true. We've never been prejudiced, I'm telling you. This is a poem about my family, my whole generation, and also me. One more. Save. Save forests, save trees, save good things for you and me. Save pandas, save giraffes, save the animals' walking paths. Save paper, save books. Books are not to tear, they are to take a look. Save houses, save them all. Don't spray graffiti on the wall.
Awesome. 10 years old. Ain't that something? Ooh. And she wrote every last one of those poems. Ain't that something? Yeah, ain't that something? Okay, our next poet is gonna be, I met this brother last year after the 49er Raiders game, and we got to rapping there, and one of the top poets in the country. In fact, he stole a show last year. Let's give a good round of applause to Roderick Klugh, Jr.
I don't know how I follow that. She was great, wasn't she? Give her a hand again. Through three poems concerning love. All of my poetry is about love or friends. First one's Pretty Brown Lady. My pretty brown lady, strong and independent, soft and warm. Your sparkling brown eyes, your radiant smile brings memories of warmth and tenderness. Touching, kissing, loving. My heart yearns for you. My eyes cry for you. My body aches for you. I love you, my pretty brown lady. No other can touch my heart, no other can fill my life, my dreams, my soul. Oh, babe, love me forever. Fill my soul with your sweet love forever and a day. For those of you that have been in love, are in love, or looking for it, there's a time. There's a time in everyone's life when they're rescued from the blue, when they find that someone new who will say, I love you. There's a time in everyone's life when they begin to see the light, when they know that love is right and their heart is oh so true. The time can be so short or the time can be so long, but no matter how we find it, the love can be so strong. It's the time in everyone's life that love will not forget true feelings that were met. Two lovers in love's song. Sometimes we meet someone and it lasts about that long. It's a special moment. Fading into the past, then into obscurity, our love reached out for that special heart in which to be. We loved so hard, so fast, so we thought, both realizing the end, not caring what our love wrought. We were special for a moment, sharing each other's heart, resting in a place of solitude, praying for that new start. Now realizations of the future with loves from the past brings new meaning to love that will last. But in every present, we will always remember the special moment that will never surrender.
I told you he steals the show. our next poet, this brother, we grew up together, and I predict that this brother is going to be the next mega name to come out of the city, the biggest name since Danny Glover. He directed the play Telling Like It Is. He's a brilliant actor and writer and producer. And he's awesome, beautiful brother, beautiful family, and a talented family. His sons write poetry, and wife, I mean, this is a beautiful brother here. And can't say enough about him, but remember the name, Wendrell James. Our next poet, Mr. Wendrell James. Let's give him a big hand.
That's quite an introduction. Good evening, everybody. It's really a pleasure to be here. I want to thank Larry and Lee for organizing this. It's really nice to have the opportunity to share some of my thoughts with you. And it's really nice to see all these young people. Young lady, you are talented. Keep on writing, Jesus Christ. I'm going to do a few poems for you tonight. The first one is Brother Misguided. My misguided brother, think hard about what you do, because it not only misrepresents me, it misrepresents your mama too. You always out trying to cheat, lie, and steal. Man, don't you know your son's got to play with the cards that you deal? There's all kind of people out there who know what you've done. What do you think what they would do, feel or do when they look up and here comes your son? Is he just like his daddy, his uncle, or all the rest? Man, we're getting tired of your mess. You often say you're doing your own thing. It doesn't have anything to do with me or your brother. But that's not the same opinion that we get from all the others. Morally dyslexic, your numbers are comparatively few. It's just a shame that what you do reflects on your mama, your daddy, your sister, your brother, your cousin, your son, your daughter, and your neighborhood too. The next poem is Snow King. For me, many dream. I come from a land where the sun is hot and the day is long. I'm often chewed in leaf form so men can carry on. From foreign lands, I'm sought by many who desire to take me home to make their wealth a plenty. At first, it seems a pleasure to share my presence, but soon your whole life is about me. I am the essence. I'm a friend to all who want to be rich, but often my poor friends wind down in a ditch. For it is not I, but the greed of man that caused the negativity to permeate throughout the land. Some people call me white powder or snow, and when you're down, I can make you go. What was once a pleasure is now a necessity. You and I, that's how it has to be. I don't play with you in a physical way. It's through the mind that I will make you pay. When you're alone or with someone at night, it's me and my presence that can make things right. All you have to do is come by me, and this seemingly weightless powder will set you free. You dare say no? We'll see how long you can go. For it's not the backaches that will call your bluff. It's the matter over mine, and believe me, it's enough. Believe me not, then simply take a test. Turn on a friend, and I'll do the rest. First, I'll show you how pleasurable I can be. But sooner, not later, that friend will wish she was free. But until that time comes, you'll share in the fun until you find out all the money is gone. Cocaine is my name and control is my game. Use me just once and I'll do you the same. The next poem I'm going to do is called Color Test. It's obvious to see when you look at me to know where I come from. Then why must I state emphatically that I am an African? The confusion of the land, inclusive of all the clans, is that I am simply black. Get back. Why must I identify this point of visual fact? For to have no homeland, as others proclaim, is an ugly rule to this life's game. This leaves us all alone with no history. To diss this, simply take a color test. Place me like you place all the rest. White skin and straight hair, tell me from where they came. Almond eyes and a yellow hue, tell me what land does this bring in mind to you. Brown skin and straight or curly hair, sounds of South America, even Africa are in the air. Various shades of black and brown, hair of curls, textures unfound. Blacks are African, this is a fact, not just something you can give and take back. To just be black is a tragedy, you see. It lessens and negates our 11,000-year history. So do not feel shame, nor ever disclaim your right to your culturally rich past. For not until then can we ever begin to rid racism and destroy its caste. Thank you.
Some great poetry there by Brother Wid, Brother Wendrell. Our next poet is going to be, this is our about seventh time doing a poetry program together. He's one of the, my opinion, this next brother is one of the top poets in the country, in the world. You're going to hear about this brother too. He's one of the top poets in the world, period. Without further ado, let me introduce the outstanding Mr. Rudolph Valentino Breland, Rudy Breland.
Thank you. I don't know about that big ado about the top poet in the world. I guess I'll be a judge someday. But I just do what I feel, and it comes from my heart, and I guess the spirit from above, and I'm just grateful that God has gave me that talent, and I'm privileged to be here today to share it. The first poem I'd like to read, I'm going to read about three or four poems, and we're going to do a Rob Robin later on, come back up, is MLK. Calling a doctor. Dr. King, where does your spirit flow? Calling a doctor. Doctor, where are you now? King, ways, king days. Sing, freedom, ring the bells of liberty. Keep the dream alive. We have a holiday, which is your birthday. This will keep your dream from fading away. This hope will not die. Your happy birthday will keep it fresh in our mind. As the holiday grows upon us with time, calling a doctor, your spirit which lives, calling Martin Luther King. This is your dream on freedom trail. Don't let it be put up on the bookshelf. Your voice sing, your preaching sing, your teaching spreads peace, stop violence. Calling the doctor, we are feeling your marching. We are boycotting our choices, voting with action in our voices. Being active, not passive. For human rights, for shelter for homeless. Calling the doctor, extinguish racism. Feed the hungry, love, not hate. Peace, not war. With all the street violence and the violence in the world these days, well, I let the poem speak for itself. Guns are not for fun. Guns are for real. Metal, deadly steel, no joke, it is for real. A deed of dark and dirty deal. Bloody bullets, they kill and hurt. No gun control, leaving a one-way street with no place to go, driving us to our death. Once alive is now dead, killing out of control. Guns in cars, behind doors, in pockets, on the street corners, killing the enemy, our friend. Guns, how many will guns kill today? How many guns will make many cry? A gun kills quicker than a knife. Kills a singer, kills a father, kills a mother, kills a sister, kills a brother. A gun to kill who you choose or who you don't choose. Guns are for real, bring death, dead end deal. Guns is to kill the feeling within. Guns to break the heart. Guns to create a river of tears. Guns to build a mountain of fear. Danger zone at home with a gun. Danger zone behind doors. Guns, a blood and sweat. Guns in a child's hand that killed a woman or man. Guns, easy way out, easy way to use and easy to abuse. Guns for protection, guns for emotion from any direction. Guns are for real. Gun is a real, dirty, and really steady, still deal. I'd like to ask you a question. I don't know, I know a few of you, but I don't know any of you personally. But the next poem, have you had your throat cut lately? We'll see about that. Are you happy, sad, or glad? Are you living or existing? Are you working, searching, reaching for the new, glued to the old while life goes on without you, to live on a ride, high or tight? Have you had your throat cut lately? Maybe by a budget butcher knife that cuts away all living existence, bring all hardships up to surface. Maybe a layoff that brings existence to a complete halt. Maybe going out of business that puts you out of touch with the living world. Have you had your throat cut lately? Have you? Have you had your throat cut lately? Inflation bringing out frustration. Taxes so much you cannot sleep. Talks of nuclear bombs dropping at your door. Food prices so high it takes away your appetite. The rich gets richer, the poor get poorer. Gas making life a high ride the price. House moving people into the streets while owning a home becomes unknown. I ask you, feel your neck. Maybe you don't know it. Maybe you don't feel it. The blood is there. Have you had your throat cut lately? Well, to give a different side of the coin, I'll leave on this round with this one. Lift. Lift your head, push on forward. Self-esteem being the mainstream. To paths of doors of hopes and dreams. Raise your voice to be clearly heard. Love, peace, and happiness are the key words. Rejoice for the freedom to be able to make a choice. Don't hang up your brain, for with it you control everything. Lift your head, push it up and push out. Elevate your heart to the highest peak. Push your soul to search and reach. It's only as difficult as you make it. The blood flows out. The lungs scream out to breathe and to spread joy about. The heart shouts out the beat of harmony of life. Lift your feeling to touch the inner feeling. Set your inspiration afire to create your true desire. Lift your spirit to burn the imagination into true smoke. Force a chain reaction. Push your emotion for a satisfaction and don't be paralyzed by worries and lies. Stay alert. Keep the reality alive. The only a believer is only a true believer and the true achiever. Thank you.
The next poet would be me. I would like to dedicate this. These poems are going to be dedications. This poem is going to be a dedication to a very special person to me and in my life. She's a very dedicated, hardworking, and loving person, and I love you madly. And that's my mother right there, Miss Mitchell. This poem is a tribute to my mother. It's entitled, "For the Lady Something Special." May a lovely summer breeze kiss you good morning. May your hearts be touched and blessed with the beauty of love and life as your life flow like an endless river. Be a lady, be yourself, and in time you'll have the best this world has to offer. Be loving, be sweet, be tender, be real, and in time you'll have the best this life has to offer. Let your hearts dream, but don't get caught in the midst of fantasy. Time spent dreaming can be time wasted unless your heart reaches for the beautiful things in the world this life has to give, this world has to offer. for the ladies something special, and that's very special to my mother there. The next poem is this beautiful young lady back here in the back, Stella there. this one is entitled The Splendor of Ghetto Suave, Sweet Expressions. Hey there, lovely lady, warm, beautiful, sweet, tender, sexy, sincere, and all of them kind of nice things. You're even more to my heart. Lady love, I've searched all of my life, looking for your kind of loving tenderness. It's beautiful and real. Oh, what is all this sweet love I feel? I see it in your eyes, and I feel your love looking through the windows of my world. And my lovely one, your smile is a warm and wonderful reflection of the love that's in your heart. And when I look into your eyes, I find myself saying, my goodness alive. Your lips sure look tasty. I bet they are very, very sweet. Lady, how are my chances? Very good, I hope. I'd be proud to be your celebrity, baby, anytime, all the time, day and night. And then we can share the beauty of and pleasure of evening walks, hand in hand, strolling through the park, stop under a palm tree, dancing in the moonlight so we can kiss and hug and whisper sweet somethings as a warm and lovely summer breeze strums sweet melodies from the strings of tender summer leaves. Baby, you and me together, it's sweet melody magic as our hearts dance in celebration of the beautiful beginning of our love affair. Hearts touch on this lovely day, sweet love smiles. Now let us listen to the sweet beat of the falling rain, beautiful music to our ears, sweet music for our hearts as we dance to love. the next poem, I would like to dedicate this to my great Aunt Alice and Aunt Elizabeth. My mother's mother's sisters, and they went to a better place, and this is especially for Aunt Elizabeth and Aunt Alice. And it won 2 national awards. I wrote this as a tribute to Martin Luther King. It's entitled, Somewhere Someone Has Said and Done Something Beautiful. Out of the midnight blue, as a gentle breeze tames the turbulent winds and the pouring rain, then as the rainy clouds parted, the sunshine smiled upon all of the people of the world. Then the eyes of the sky opened and gave us a beautiful day in the sun. Then people opened their eyes with a profound respect for life. Then people opened their hearts and gave love that filled other people's hearts with appreciation for life. Then people opened their minds, the reservoirs of wisdom, and poured golden knowledge into the mainstreams of society. As hearts of love and rhythm with life get ready to set sail, from which the ships of friendship will sail, carrying the cargo of love, trust, unity, brotherhood, friendship, and understanding. The raging seas have mellowed down from the love-touched waves. Tranquility and sweet serenity is the music we hear. Somewhere someone has said and done something beautiful. I've touched upon every shore as my desire to rise to the golden heights. Inspiration elevated my heart, and I soared above every mountain. I spoke of unity for all mankind, and the skies were peacefully filled in fire, in rain, and in darkness. In times of a storm, in times of uncertainty, I know that there will be sunshine because somewhere someone has said and done something beautiful. And that's that poem. And then the next poem, thank you. Another special dedication is to Mr. Will Hammond, Sr., a very fine gentleman. He's deceased, and he was one of the original founders of the Hunters Point Bayview Co-op, and that's our history and that's our heritage, and it's important that we acknowledge and respect that, and we remember. God bless you there, Mr. Hammond. The next poem I would like to dedicate this to Tangela Collins, her for her 18th birthday. This one is entitled, Love is Life. Love is life, and life is so very, very nice. When the atmosphere is pleasant and thoughts are peaceful, life of living is like a warm and beautiful feeling, touching you, touching your heart. As you look into the beautiful horizons, you see children playing warm and safe under the loving eyes of the friendly skies, vivacious, energetic, and so full of life. And love is life. As the wonderfulness of the day settles in, something warm touch your heart and kiss you good morning. May life be beautiful to you, and may life be beautiful for you. Happy birthday, Dad, Tangent. Our next poet is going to be Brother Dwayne here. This brother's another talented writer, and I met him early in the year, and I look for a lot of great poetry from this brother. So let's give Brother Dwayne here a great hand.
Good evening. I come to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and I'm going to recite some poems the Lord gave me. It's Surrender, Solution, and Salvation. Surrender says, many times I find it hard to express myself, afraid to open my mouth, walking around depressed, knowing things could be better by just letting it out. Seeking answers about the emotions I feel, not enjoying life, accepting that it's real. If I would just try, put forth some effort and relax, there's God who's always on time, never late to pick up your slack. When times get tough, I mean really hard, I want you to know someone's there, the Lord God. Solution. Lord, hear the prayer I pray, that you right my wrongs that I do each day. Send down your prayer and a healing hand. Let peace reign throughout your land. Strengthen the youth who must carry on, that the time will come when the elders are gone. Yes, rid this land of its evil dope and replace it with everlasting hope. To you, O Lord, I give thanks and praise, for it was you who brought me through these days. When times get tough and seems like no one here, I know there's a God who's always near. You're a wonderful Father, always forgiving, even when I'm living the worst kind of living. I find love and peace that some haven't heard, and which I find in your word, which is the truth of word. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And this is salvation. Rejoice in the Lord, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Let us rejoice in the Lord, for Jesus died on the cross for our sin. Let us rejoice in the Lord, for Jesus arose. Let us rejoice in the Lord. When we woke up this morning, rejoice in the Lord for this day. God bless you.
Our next poet is going to be, I work with this brother here, and you know, we talk a lot, and this brother is a talented musician, and another name to remember, he's going to be a monster talent. Our next poet is Philip Hadley. Let's give a big hand to Philip.
Good evening. It's nice to be here tonight. It's really like my second chance ever to share my poetry with someone other than by the phone. And I'm going to do three poems for you tonight. The first one I'm going to do is entitled By My Brother's Hand, because I feel that I have a responsibility to my people to state what I see going on. The second poem I'm going to do is one that is about nature, has to do with our environment, because I believe we have a responsibility. And my third poem will be a love poem. I wrote this poem on napkins, and it's kind of hard to see. I was sitting in Subway. Let's see. Okay, let me just kind of get the little jitters that I got. Okay, one second. All right. All right. By my brother's hand. I looked into the eyes of a demon, and I saw he longed for those good old days when blacks were strapped, whipped up and down their backs, and cry and bleed as he strapped to the tree. But as he pleased, no one to hear his plea, no NAACP, no emancipation proclamation, just a white man's whip and a strong indignation and hatred for what he knows to be true, that blacks will advance no matter what he may do. He wishes there never was a Malcolm X. Black history's been hidden from the U.S. school text, never being told what was really done, how black children were murdered, how our black men were hung, brutalized in countless cases, our black sisters raped on a daily basis. But I swear sometimes it seems we forget and act as if slavery never did exist, when it still does. Though it be a different kind and during a different time, the shackles taken off our ankles and placed on our minds, and maybe even harder to escape, when we refuse to recognize that we're still being raped. Demons got us raping one another. Fatherless children are selling crack to our brothers. Blacks killing blacks for scraps from the white man's table. I wish this was a fable, but in reality, as far as I can see, we got a long way to go before we're gonna be free. You see, brothers and sisters, it's time for revival. It is a necessity for the black man's survival. We must awaken those who sleep, give hope and vision to those who are weak, and from hope we gain strength to race for the prize. Freedom's on the horizon, freedom's peace of mind. Love for our sisters and love for our brothers, but first love for ourselves. Because if we don't love ourselves, then we really can't have true wealth. And we can't reach out and share that love with others. And just as the flowers wither, so do our brothers. And our women and children live on in distress as another black man is laid down to rest. Yeah, I looked into the eyes of a demon, but I made a mistake. It's not the old days he was singing. You see, he's got a new whip and a whole new game plan. Destruction of the black man by his own brother's hand. Thank you.
That is.
Thank you. Thank you. I thank you for that response. Like I said, next poem here, there's a, it's gonna take it down a little bit this time. Oh yeah, I can match that. You know, I don't even have a title for this poem right here. I'm just gonna call it Eternal Things. In life, sometimes there are disappointments, time that make you want to cry. There's pain, there's tears, there's loneliness. There's loss of life and so much strife. And all who live and all who breathe, all who feel and all who care, all are linked by this chain. Tell me who has not yet felt the rain? Sojourners in a world of sin, a pilgrim's journey midst the wind, of mountains high and valleys low, of oceans deep and progress slow, of beauty seen but overlooked, the flowers tear, the earth is shook, the trees that stood now dead to lay, to burn, to rot, to drift, decay. We claim intelligence for we can build, yet everything we touch we kill. Poisoning the earth's own life, is man so smart, is man so right? Spin to build and build to fight, fast approaching is the night. Things not live worth more than life, tell me when we'll end the strife. As of now, the birds still sing. To their maker, their voices ring. There once were many, but now we're few. Extinction's the torture they've been put through. Exploit, abuse, misuse, and trample. Living worse with each example. And those who learn from life's long past are hunted down to be killed at last. A justice of our own kind. Self-deceived and happy blind. All life efforts for earthly means. denying the weight of eternal things. That's it. I got so much I want to do here and share with you, but let me see. I'm gonna try to. Okay, thank you. Okay, this one here is gonna be. It's entitled "What You See Is What You Get," and this is from a strictly male perspective. So, ladies, watch out. I really like this poem right here, but it's when I say it's from a male's perspective, I mean it's just basically something that's true, you know, because a lot of brothers out here. And as a black man, it's already kind of rough. We all know that. It's rough as a sister. And everybody's really just trying to make it. And the only thing a brother really wants is somebody that's going to stick by his side. You know, I know that's what I want. Okay, here we go. Most of it is in the memory, but I don't want to forget it. It's called "What You See Is What You Get." It's like this. 1 second, just get rid of this other stuff so I won't get confused up here. Okay. Here we go.
All right.
Ladies, right now I don't have much, girl, as far as material things go. But what I've got, I'll share with you just to let you know that I care for you. You see, all right now, all I got is me in a pocket full of dreams, a bright future and some time for you. But unfortunately, it seems that it's just not enough for you, not the lifestyle you're accustomed to. Despite the fact I'm young and black and making it despite these whack people trying to hold me down, keep me down and kick me around. But you ain't seen the entire picture. You just seen the scenes they sent you. And now they got you gold digging, trying to tear me down to support your living. You want it all at once and it's just not that simple. It's gonna take more than pretty dimples to help you get ahead in life. So you might as well just treat me right. After all, I understand this game, how society has got you trained. But if you can love me for who I am, what I am, and understand that right now I'm investing in my mind and that the perks of life will come in time, then we really have a chance at this. And that's kind of rare, true happiness. You see, we've got to learn to look beyond, see the rising sun before the dawn, judge the heart and one's intent, loving even if no money's spent. Even if, for after all, the reverse is true, I too must love you just for you. Even if nothing in your hands you bring, just bring your love, girl, just bring your dreams. And together we'll make each one come true. Believe in me as I believe in you. That's it. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you. I thank you again. I appreciate that. We'll see you next year.
I told you we had some monster poets, some of the greatest poets in the world up here. Is there any doubt now? Coming to you live from Hunters Point, California. our next poet is this is Julia Wimberly's nephew. I met him at one of the business seminars and. This brother's another talented poet, and his name is Bo Wimberly, so let's give Brother Bo a great hand.
Amen. I wrote this poem about a good friend of mine. She's a woman, single parent, and she has a lot of strength, a lot of good qualities, and strength is one of them. That's one that stands prominent. I wrote this for everyone who ever had a chance to appreciate a woman, and everyone who ever had the chance to utter the word mama. So that covers just about everyone. It simply reads woman, simply titled woman. Woman, mysterious is she, for she loves from the heart. Viewing the surface, cannot measure the depth of her love. Although her face shows grief, she gives to the indigent. Love her and lead her, and she will be great. Woman. You are mine. I grow when challenged. You have helped me grow. You are mine, challenged. Man responsible to lead woman. You are mine, challenged. You have pierced my heart with your convictions. You are mine, challenged. Your love has helped me to remain free from desolation. Today I search to gather strength. You are mine, challenged. Open your arms and embrace destiny. You are mine, challenged. The woman of my desire, much love, I love, in love. This progression has made me a happy man. Fire burns within my soul for the woman of my desire. Every emotion is satisfied by the love God saw fit to trust me with. I will never let go of my love for the Father or my love for the woman of my desire. As long as I live, my love will live. As long as I breathe, my love will breathe. As long as I feel, I long to touch you. As long as I see, I will look to you, for you are the woman of my desire. No one else can compare to the love God has made especially for me. You are the woman of my desire. The chosen. When we go home, may he make us perfect. And may we sit by his throne and be glad he chose us to do his will. My life is no life without the way, the truth, and the life. I've been admiring you. Your thirst for life calls me higher. I know God has you in hand. Knowledge of you brings my heart joy. We have a covenant. Few will enjoy. Many are called, but we are chosen. Thank you.
Okay, our next poet, Brother Andrew introduced me to this young lady, and she recited a poem to me yesterday, and I said, I only had one thing to say, monstrous. So our next poet is Shirley McCoy. Let's give her a great round of applause.
Time, and it really is an honor and a pleasure to be asked to share some of my poetry. And the title of this is African Pride. Is this okay? Beautiful black brothers and sisters, be thankful for your African heritage that's full of pride. You're heirs of a great continent, once ruled by kings and queens, whose voices are still crying on the wind to let freedom ring. As a people, you were robbed. Robbed of your freedom, land, and gold. But your pride and faith, you still hold. So let the love of your race become your struggle for liberation against all unlawful bans. To strengthen our voices so we become countless as the sands. Beautiful black brothers and sisters, embrace your African pride. You're crowned with the highest of honor, adorned with dignity and grace, intelligent, agile warriors of strength, leaders of nonviolence and patience. You are the epitome of a great nation. Beautiful black brothers and sisters, share your African pride. You have inherited a great legacy of wealth. You're gifted with knowledge, creativity, and talent. Your culture is girded with love, faith, hope, and pride to embrace unity at home and across the miles. You are the creators and masters of a unique style. Beautiful black brothers and sisters, love your African pride. Your spirit bears roots throughout the motherland. The beauty of your soul is reflected in your eyes. The grit of your pride is a mirror of your style. The strength of your faith is stronger than the weight on your brows. The charisma of your power will help bring about a better day for your children and their children, watching and learning from the lifestyles you portray. Beautiful black brothers and sisters, remember to be thankful, to embrace, to share, and to love your African pride. Thank you.
I was telling Sister Shirley that it was a breeze. Like George Benson said, breezing. Our next poet is going to be this brother knows my father, Reverend Ware. His name is Kenneth Newkirk, so he's going to come up and do a poem for you. And Lee's going to follow, the Olivier, she's going to follow Kenneth with some beautiful poetry. Kenneth? Let's give him a big hand. Okay.
I didn't know anything about this event. It was luckily I wrote a poem in May to a Sparrowgrass Poetry Forum, and come to find out my poem got accepted for publication into a worldwide magazine. Thank you. I had met Mr. Ware, Larry, over the telephone. I was introduced to him by his father. I come here tonight for some other business. And my mother told me she sent me this back, so reading this. I only have one. The title of this poem is called Locked Up. I've done an illegal thing and have been convicted of a crime. The judge and district attorney have agreed to give me time. Whether I agree with the outcome, no one really care. A cell jail wall, I will begin to stare. I will not allow doubt, depression, or sadness to enter my home. I don't believe all hope is gone. When I give up, my freedom is over. A faithless person in search of a four-leaf clover. As long as I forgive myself, everything will be fine, because locked up is only a state of mind.
Outstanding. We'll introduce the next poet. This lady, she does a really beautiful job here at the Bayview Wadden branch, and they're so dedicated. Lee Olivier and the staff there, they go out of their ways to really help our patrons, and we want full participation out of the patrons in our neighborhood and show that we have pride in our library and our schools and our neighborhood. And as I said, Lee works tireless hours and works very hard. Dana, Ballantyne, and the rest of the staff, I mean, they really go out of their way. So Lee's gonna come up and do some poetry, but uh, let's give her a big hand because she works so hard. I mean, I can't say enough about Lee.
Well, I wish I could say I was a poet. I'm not a poet. I'm a poet appreciator. And I have become a major fan of Maya Angelou, and I wanted to read two of her poems to you to close this first segment. The first one is called Take Time Out. When you see them on a freeway, hitching rides, wearing beads, with packs by their sides, you ought to ask, what's all the warring and the jarring and the killing and the thrilling all about? Take time out. When you see him with a band around his head and an army surplus bunk that makes his bed, you'd better ask, what's all the beating and the cheating and the bleeding and the needing all about? Take time out. When you see her walking barefoot in the rain and you know she's tripping on a one-way train, you need to ask, what's all the lying and the dying and the running and the gunning all about? Take time out. Use a minute, feel some sorrow for the folks who think tomorrow is a place that they can call up on the phone. Take a month and show some kindness for the folks who thought that blindness was an illness that affected eyes alone. If you know that youth is dying on the run and my daughter trades dope stories with your son, we'd better see what all our fearing and our jeering and our crying and our lying brought about. Take time out. I love this lady. I'm going to see her. She's in town this next week. The last one I want to do is called On Aging. When you see me sitting quietly like a sack left on the shelf, don't think I need your chattering. I'm listening to myself. Hold, stop, don't pity me. Hold, stop your sympathy. Understanding if you got it, otherwise I'll do without it. When my bones are stiff and aching and my feet won't climb the stair, I will only ask one favor. Don't bring me no rocking chair. When you see me walking, stumbling, don't study and get it wrong. 'Cause tired don't mean lazy, and every goodbye ain't gone. I'm the same person I was back then, a little less hair, a little less chin, a lot less lungs, and much less wind. But ain't I lucky I can still breathe in? The last thing I wanted to tell you is the library's got lots of good poetry. There's a sample of some of it over there. This is from the library. You can check this out. You can check that out. You can check others out there. So come and see us.
Wow. Wasn't that a great show, people? I would like to give a very special thank you to all of the poets who attended and participated. Old Brother Philip over there. Brother Gary. Let's give a hand there. Let's give Brother Bo Wimberly a hand. Give Sister Shirley here a hand. Brother Wendrell, a hand. Mr. Rudy Breland, a hand there. And Amanda Shelton, let's get us this one. Brother Kenneth, let's give him a round of applause. And Brother Roderick here, let's give him a great round of applause.